Hi, welcome to the tutorial TextPad Widget Part 1. In this tutorial, we'll learn how to use a text editor with the TextPad Widget. The objective here is to open, edit, and save files via the HMI application. This makes it possible to do things like create and edit shift logs. A map view visualization object has already been added to my project, as you can see here. In order to edit the files from the HMI application, we need to add the MP file manager configuration. This configuration can only be used in combination with a MapView HMI application. For information about which widgets can use this configuration, see Automation Help. In the configuration, we can define which storage media will be used and set role-based access rights. The storage media that the widget should have access to later on must be specified under Devices. We'll use HD. The storage media has already been defined in the target system configuration. Under Folder, we can define which of its folders are permitted to be accessed. To allow access to all the folders, select All. The next step is to define which user roles will have access to the folder. If this is set to Everyone, for example, even users who are not logged in will be able to access the folder. Additional access rights, like whether the specified user is permitted to read and edit files, are defined under Rights. Finally, we need to add the widget for editing the text files. The TextPad widget can be used to edit and save text files. For more information about configuration, see the Automation Help. The next step is to navigate to the content that should be included in the text editor. Then drag and drop the TextPad widget onto the content. We'll add two button widgets that allow us to load and save files. The first button will open a file explorer to select a file. To do this, we need to create an action event binding that starts the action Open File Explorer when the button is clicked. The second button can then be used to save files after they have been edited. We'll do this by adding another action event binding that triggers the action Save As when the button is clicked. For more information about the TextPad widget, see Automation Help. Finally, you need to make sure that the MP server library has been added. This is used for internal communication between map services and map view. Once we have downloaded our changes onto the controller, we're ready to open the HMI application in the web browser. Here, we can see the text editor where the files can be opened and edited. To do this, first click on the Open File Explorer button. Then navigate to the desired file and click Open to open the file. The content of the file is now displayed in the TextPad widget and can be edited as needed. The file can then be saved again by clicking the Save As button, which lets you save it under a new name. If the name is the same, you can simply overwrite the original file. As you can see, it's very easy to use a text editor to edit and save files using MapView. Thanks for watching.